Hello, everybody. Today we are going to take a look at Mortal Kombat, directed by Simon McQuoid and starring Louis Tan, Jessica McNamee, and Joe Taslim. This is, of course, based on the video game series of the same name and is effectively a reboot of the film franchise that started way back in 1995 with Mortal Kombat and shat the bed 2 years later with Mortal Kombat Annihilation. Similar to the 1995 movie, Shang Tsung and his Outworld warriors will have the opportunity to take over Earthrealm if they can win 10 straight victories in Mortal Kombat. And they have won 9. No pressure, Earthrealm. Unlike the 1995 movie, Shang Tsung would rather not leave anything to chance and instead prefers to just kill off all of Earth's warriors ahead of time, effectively winning the tournament before it even happens. But Earth's warriors aren't about to just roll over and die, thank you very much. And they fight. A lot. Naturally, I don't expect a whole lot from video game adaptations because they tend to suck. That said, in recent years, we have seen a handful of video game adaptations that actually had some honest-to-God effort put into them, and they at least turned out decent, like Detective Pikachu and Sonic. And Mortal Kombat turned out to be another one in the decent pile. It's not great, it's kinda stupid, but I'll be damned if I didn't have fun. I got the sense watching this that the people behind this movie were trying to stay true to the games overall, and I think they largely succeeded with all the good and bad that comes with it. The story, by the movie's own admission, is pretty dumb. Come on, Sonya, a martial arts tournament to save the world? Don't you think that sounds pretty ridiculous? And look, they even spelled combat wrong. And like the video game series on which this movie is based, they crank the violence up to 11. The very first fight scene in this movie, Scorpion throws his kunai right into a guy's head and yanks it out, and there's this fountain of blood that pours out, and I'm like, oh, okay, you have my attention. This is definitely not the PG-13 Mortal Kombat from the 90s. They went for the hard R. As they should. The character design was really good, pretty much dead on. Every time another character comes on screen, I'm like, yep, there's Sonya, there's Jax, there's Raiden, and so on. And not just the design, but they cast the parts pretty well too. And it was very cool to see Joe Taslim as Sub-Zero. Anytime someone from the raid shows up, you know I'm on board, because that means shit's about to get real. There was a pretty funny interview I saw with Mikad Brooks, who plays Jax, who said he made the mistake of watching the raid before they started filming. He's like, I gotta fight this guy? Oh shit, what did I sign up for? And because the character design and the casting was so good, Louis Tan's character, Cole Young, confused the hell out of me when he showed up because I had no idea who he was supposed to be. Turns out he was not in the games, though I expect he will be at some point in the future. He was a new character created just for the movie. While he does have a connection to another character from the franchise, he is a down-on-his-luck MMA fighter who's just trying to make a living and protect his family. But then he gets chosen for Mortal Kombat and everything goes to hell. And while I thought the character of Cole Young was perfectly fine, I'm not really sure why they felt the need to create a new character. I mean, there are some characters in Mortal Kombat whose backstories are really not all that exciting, and honestly, they could have taken, say, Liu Kang, for example, who was the hero of the original movie, and I believe the original game as well, and just given him the exact same backstory, and it would have worked just fine. And do you like fan service? Well, boy, does this movie have fan service. They stuck it in at every available opportunity, no matter how cheesy. Sometimes I think they did it because it was cheesy, which, honestly, I kind of respect. It is a Mortal Kombat movie, so of course you gotta check off all the boxes. Kano wins! Check. Flawless victory. Check. The fight scenes, of which there are many, were, I thought, pretty good overall. Again, they are gory as hell, as they should be, it's Mortal Kombat. There were a few bits here and there, however, where the editing looked a little janky, especially in Sonya's fights. Not sure if that was necessarily the actress's fault, probably more a combination of the choreography and the editing. Visual effects are also pretty good. Obviously, technology has greatly improved since the 1995 movie, although I went back and watched that recently, and Goro still holds up pretty well. Reptile does not. There's none of that primitive CGI here. Reptile actually looks decent. As does Goro, for that matter. I was a little disappointed with Natara because that character wasn't given a whole lot to do, though considering how many characters they crammed into this movie, I guess it was inevitable that someone had to get shoved aside. A little disappointed that we got Melina, but no Kitana. That was weird. And I do wish they had done a bit more with Scorpion, who's played by Hiroyuki Sanada. The movie actually begins with a flashback showing the backstory of Scorpion and Sub-Zero, but then we never really see Scorpion again until the very end of the movie. And honestly, I thought the story of Scorpion and Sub-Zero was more interesting than the main plot. What little we did get of Scorpion was pretty awesome. I wanted more. I was also a little confused over whether the tournament actually happened. Like, were all of these fights between the Earth and Outworld Warriors technically tournament fights, or was this just, like, the warm-up? So there were a few things I could have done better, but overall, it did exactly what a Mortal Kombat movie should do, and I had a lot of fun with it. I would say it is worth paying money to see it in a theater if you are in a position where you can safely do so, and if not, it's on HBO Max. They do tease a sequel at the end of the movie, and it looks like there is at least one classic character who will be joining our heroes if the sequel happens, and I hope it does because I want more of this insanity. Hopefully, this sequel will be better than the last time they tried, although I can't imagine it being much worse. And that's all I have to say about Mortal Kombat. Until next time, take care.